Hi, my name is Kasia Vaver. I'm an engineer on the Keyboards UI team, and today I'll be your guide to the wonderful world of keyboard layout. I am incredibly excited to talk to you today about bringing the keyboard from a frame-based past into an auto layout future. We'll start our tour by talking about the new guide. Then we'll go over some of the new things you'll be able to do to more fully integrate the keyboard into your layout. And finally, we'll talk about what a keyboard really is, philosophically speaking, types of keyboards to consider, and some of the cases you might not think about right away. So let's get started with our tour. As with many things, this one begins in the ancient past. If you have worked with the keyboard in your app before, you know the way that it's been handled since time immemorial is by registering for notifications, deriving the appropriate offsets and animations from the information in the notification, doing some math, and finally, using that to adjust your layout. Now, notifications are sticking around. We are not deprecating them. You can learn more about them if you're interested in The Keys to a Better Text Input Experience from 2017. Let's look at a quick example of how notifications might be used with a custom guide. Now, don't copy any of this code because we're about to replace it. But here's how you handled the keyboard before iOS 15. You'd create your custom guide and anchors to respond to notifications. Then you'd register for the appropriate notifications. Usually at least will show and will hide, but sometimes frame changes, etc. Then you'd respond to the notifications by getting the frame information from the notification, making sure that you're adjusting for your own views and the safe area guide if the keyboard is leaving the screen. And you'd get the animation info from the notification, and finally, change your guide to match. Now, it's not a ton, but it can get complicated quickly. Today, I'm happy to announce a brand new addition to the Auto Layout collection, UI Keyboard Layout Guide. Now, try to constrain your excitement as we dive into this. Keyboard Layout Guide is brand new in iOS 15. It's a layout guide. You can constrain the views and guides in your existing layout to it. If you're not familiar with layout guides, a layout guide is a way to represent space in a layout without using a view. It has all the same anchors as a view. The Keyboard Layout Guide will represent the space that the keyboard occupies in your app so that your layout can account for it. And that's it. Mostly. Let's talk about updating that code we just saw to use this instead. Here's that notifications code. Don't copy it yet, wait for the green check mark. So, now you can go ahead and remove that anchor you were tracking and change from your layout guide to the view's keyboard layout guide. And we don't need to register for notifications anymore, and we don't need to respond to them either. And that's it. All that code boils down to this single line. Ready to see it in action? Here's what it looks like to bring up the keyboard when using the notifications code. And here's what it looks like to bring it up using the guide. You may have noticed that, other than their localizations, those looked virtually identical, but that's kind of the point. You don't have to do nearly as much, and you get the same result. So let's talk about updating to the guide. It's a property on UI View. And for most cases, you'll just update to using the guide's top anchor. The guide matches keyboard animations like bring up and dismiss, and it follows height changes too. Because sometimes the keyboard is taller and sometimes it's shorter. But the guide will adapt to fit whatever size appears. And when the keyboard is undocked, by default, the guide will drop to the bottom of the screen and be the width of your window, and anything you've tied to the top anchor will follow. It accounts for safe area inset, so you don't have to worry about that anymore either. For basic uses, that's probably all you need to know. But now we get to talk about the fun stuff. Why did we choose to use a new class and not just a normal layout guide? Well, we wanted you to be able to do more than you've ever been able to do with the keyboard. Our next stop is full keyboard integration into your app. Why do I say integration? Well, I have often heard people talking about the keyboard as something they need to avoid, or as something fighting with their layout. But the keyboard is part of your app. One of the main motivations behind UI Keyboard Layout Guide is to give you, the developer, the ability to respond to the many different ways we have for users to input text, and let you really fully think of the keyboard as a part of your layout in a way that maybe you haven't been able to before. I am really excited to see how you take advantage of these new features. So our next stop, what makes Keyboard Layout Guide not just a layout guide? With UI Keyboard Layout Guide, you have the ability to fully follow the keyboard in all its incarnations, if you so choose, by using a new property, follows_undocked_keyboard. It's false by default, but if you set it to true, the guide will follow the keyboard when it's undocked or floating, giving you a lot of control over how your layout responds to wherever the keyboard may be. No more automatic drop to bottom, no listening for hide keyboard notifications when undocking. The layout guide is where the keyboard is. The thing about having that information, though, is that it means you have to be a lot more conscious of how your layout is responding to different types of keyboards. So, UI Keyboard Layout Guide is a subclass of another new layout guide, UI Tracking Layout Guide. We call it a tracking layout guide because it tracks the constraints you want to change when it moves around the screen. You can give it an array of constraints that activate when near a specific edge and deactivate when leaving it, and or an array that activates when specifically away from an edge and deactivates when near it. Let's look at an example of what you can do with this and the code you need to achieve it. Here's a test app. I have a text field and some controls that can sit on the keyboard, but when it gets too close to the top of the screen, I want them to drop to the bottom to avoid going off screen. And when the keyboard moves side to side, I want the rest of the UI to shift a bit to give it a little more space. So, how is all this accomplished? We're going to look at some code here. In the following slides, the edit view is the view with the text field and controls, and the image view is the image view. Okay, note that we should be using identifiers here, and you will see that in the sample code, but this fits better on a slide. Let's start with what's happening on the vertical axis. First, we define an array that ties the bottom of the edit view to the keyboard layout guide's top. Then, we set those to be active only when the guide is away from the top, so that they'll be deactivated when it's near it. Then, we define a separate array of constraints that we want for when the keyboard gets close to the top of the view. So, instead of the top of the keyboard layout guide, we use the safe area's bottom. Here's a quick visual to help. Here's the guide and the edit view. It's currently away from top, so the away from top constraints are active, but as you move the guide closer to the top, the away from constraints are deactivated, and the near top constraints are activated, dropping it down to the bottom of the view. When we're back away from the top, the reverse happens. Now, let's look at horizontal movement. When the keyboard is away from both the leading and trailing edges, I want the edit view to be at the center of the keyboard. I want the image view to be centered in the view as well. So, I define those constraints and set them to be active when I'm away from both leading and trailing. Now let's set up what happens when we approach an edge. I want the edit view to move over to trailing when we're at the trailing edge and leading to leading. So first let's take care of that. I want the image view to move out of the way of the keyboard a little. So when we're near either edge, I move it from the center to the opposite side from the keyboard, leading to leading when the keyboard's on the trailing edge and vice versa. Then I just set these to be active when I'm near the proper edge. They'll be activated when the keyboard crosses into that region and deactivated when it leads. And that's it. Super advanced keyboard integration into your very own layout. Let's take a look at what that looks like one more time. There's my edit view. It stays with the floating keyboard, and as we move towards the top, it drops to the bottom. And as we move side to side, the adjustments we just talked about happen. Pretty cool. Next, let's talk about what near and away from mean for the keyboard. A docked keyboard is considered to be near the bottom and away from the other edges. Undocked and split keyboards can be away from all edges, or they can get near the top edge. When it's the floating keyboard, it can be near or away from any edge, and it can even be near two adjacent edges at the same time. This can lead to some potentially interesting conflicts that you should be aware of. Now, all of this only applies when you set follows undocked keyboard to true. And for the rest of the talk, that's the assumption we'll be making. Okay, final stretch. Considerations for full keyboard integration. A keyboard is a keyboard is a keyboard. Until it's not. When you choose to follow the undocked keyboard, you have some extra things to think about. So, what sorts of things should you be paying attention to when designing your layout? Always remember that the floating keyboard can be away from everything. Do you have sufficient information to be laid out correctly if it's away from all edges? Also, what should happen when the keyboard is away from the bottom edge or near the top edge? you want to be very careful with what's tied to the top anchor of the keyboard as well, because it can get way up there, so be careful. The way to resolve that is to set constraints when the keyboard is away from the bottom edge that move those views off of the top anchor of the keyboard and down to the bottom of the safe area layout guide. A user can also move the keyboard at any time, so you can't count on it being anywhere specific. You'll want to keep that in mind as well. Here's a rare specimen, the split keyboard. Split and undocked keyboards are away from all edges until it gets too close to the top. As with a docked keyboard, it's always away from leading and trailing as well. Let's talk about some new stuff. There's a new way to get text into your app this year using the camera. It's still a keyboard, so it will still be able to use the guide. It's the same as a regular docked keyboard, but it's one of the few keyboards that can be pretty much full screen. To learn more about taking advantage of text input via the camera this year, tune into Use the Camera for Keyboard Input in Your App. Continuing with new things, what about when there's a hardware keyboard attached? Well, new this year, we have an adaptive shortcuts bar that is no longer always full width. It changes width based on what language you're using and how many buttons are in the bar. Previously, it was always the full width of the screen. But now, if you're following the undocked keyboard, you can actually use the real leading and trailing edges of the bar. So what's the story here with edges? This is always near the bottom, and in its normal position, it's away from the other three edges. But it's collapsible. If you collapse it, it can also be near the leading or trailing edge. This is one of several reasons why you might want to be careful about using the width anchor of the keyboard, by the way. It can be very small, or it can be the full width of the screen. Now, let's get into the most fun part of the tour. What about if you're not the only app on screen and you're following the undocked keyboard? First, remember that the keyboard can leave your app space. When that happens, we're going to treat it as though it's been dismissed. Second, when your app is at its narrowest, the top and bottom edges are in play, but leading and trailing will stay away from, whether the keyboard is over your app or not. Also, the guide is sized for what part of the keyboard is over your app's window if you're not the only thing on screen. Let's take a look at some visuals to show you what I mean. All of this only applies if you have follows undocked keyboard set to true. If you haven't, the guide is at the bottom of the screen, the full width of your window. When you're full screen and the keyboard is floating and in the middle, you're away from everything. All of your away from constraints have been activated and all of your near constraints have been deactivated. When another app is on screen, if you're the wider app, you're still wide enough for the keyboard to be able to be away from everything. But it needs to move less to be near a horizontal edge. This is similar to being in portrait, too. But at half screen, the keyboard in the same spot is now near your leading edge, and the guide has gotten sized to match only the part of the keyboard that's over your app. When you're the narrow app, the guide is always considered to be away from the horizontal edges, the same as an iPhone or a docked keyboard, but you can still be near the top edge. And notice that again, the guide is sized to account for the portion over your app only. And when you dock the keyboard and it's full-sized again, it's also away from leading, trailing, and top. And notice again that the layout guide is once again sized for what's over your app. If you're a slide-over app, it will resize for that as well. With the previous examples and our demo code, this should all be well handled. You just have to keep in mind that you might be in any one of these scenarios. You should now be ready to bring your app to the next level of keyboard integration. So, use Keyboard Layout Guide. If your app can, take advantage of the advanced features of UITracking Layout Guide. And, most importantly, if you've been thinking about keyboard layout as fighting or avoiding the keyboard, start thinking about integrating it into your layout instead. And if you've already been thinking about it that way, now you have even more tools to realize your full vision. That brings us to the end of our tour. Please make sure you have all your personal items before exiting. Don't forget to visit the gift shop, and have a great WWDC.